बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। हाउ आर यू स्टूडेंट्स? होप ऑल ऑफ़ यू विल बी फाइन। अपर योर काउंट डाउन
एज वी आर डूइंग द एक्सरसाइज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 2,
दैट इज़ नंबर ऑपरेशन। सो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व पेज नंबर 97, क्वेश्चंस ऑन पेज नंबर 97। एज वी हैव डन आर पार्ट प्रॉब्लम स्टिल आर क्वेश्चन नंबर 5, सो नेक्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व इट स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द क्वेश्चन नंबर 6। So students, let's start our word problems. Here I am reading the statement first. Sarah and her three friends. How many friends? Three friends. Okay. Sold an equal number of raffle tickets for a charity. Okay, students. Sarah and her three friends have sold the tickets for to give in the charity. If they sold 640 tickets altogether. So students, if they have sold 640 tickets in the total, how many tickets were sold by each of them? So students, you are going to tell me that how many tickets were sold by each of them, which means that her each friend and she have sold how many tickets per head. Okay students, so first of all, here we will write the total number of friends that are Sarah and his three friends. So students, one is Sarah and her three friends, which will be 1 plus 3 and that will be 4 in the total. Okay students, and what are the amount of tickets? That are 640 tickets. So students, we are going to divide it. We are going to divide this number by the total number of persons, that are the 4. So students, in your notebook you are going to need ready the neat sketch of your word problems. Here I have written the question number 6, word problems, exercise, and my question. So students, here in the statement you are going to write the total friends. You can also write it here total people, total persons, or the persons. Okay, so students, how many friends are in total? As we have calculated, one is Sarah and his three friends. So students, there will be 4 in the total. Here I am writing the number 4 that are in the total. Next, number of tickets that are sold, and they are 640. How many number of tickets that are sold? They are 640. And in the next, that is the question, you are going to tell that how many tickets are sold by each of them. So students, sold by each of them, or each of them sold. Here I have written each of them sold. So students, here we are going to find out this one. So I am marking a question mark in front of this. Next is our solution. Come towards our solution. So students, here we know that we are going to divide the number of tickets by the total friends. Here in the number of tickets we are having 640 tickets, and the total number of students are 4. So 4 will be our divisor. So students, let's divide it. Firstly, compare the two digits 4 with the 6. 6 is being greater, so we can divide it. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, as 8 is being bigger from the number 6. So I am writing here 4 ones are 4. In the next step, that is subtraction, let's do the subtraction. 6 minus 4 is 2. Here the 2 is being smaller from my divisor. Can't divide it further without bringing this 4 down here. Now this number will become the number 24. Let's divide it further. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, 4 fours are 16, 4 fives are 20, and 4 sixes are 24. Now look at this, students. I have divided this number 24 as it is. Now the process of subtraction, when I'm going to subtract it, 4 minus 4 is 0, 2 minus 2 is 0. So I'm not gonna write it here. But students, look at this, the part of my dividend is left. I can't left it as it is without any attendance with the divisor. So students, here I am bringing this 0 down here. And now in the next step,
look at this, 4 ones are 4, can't write the 4 beneath here, but I can write 4 zeros are 0 beneath this 0. Okay students, I can write it. Now in the next step, 0 minus 0 is 0. Now this 0 is my remainder, or the you can say it, we are having no remainder of this question. We have solved it completely. Now students, here in the quotient is answer of our this question, each of them solved. So students, here with the I am writing it here as each of them solved and my answer of this question. Look at this, I have solved my question writing with the answer, and each of them solved is 160. Okay students, look, we have solved our question number 6. Now come towards the question number 7. Here is question number 7. Every cage in the zoo can accommodate 8 birds. So students, in every cage, in one cage, we can accommodate how many birds? 8 birds. Okay. How many cages are needed to accommodate 296 birds? So students, in total, we are having the 296 birds, and we want to know that how many cages are required to accommodate these 296 birds, while in one cage we are having the 8 birds. So students, we can easily solve this question by the division. Let's write the statement first and then solving this question. So students, here I have written the statements of the questions. Bird in a cage, that are the 8 birds in one cage, and in the next, total number of birds. So students, our total number of birds are 296. Okay, now come towards our question portion, that how many cages are needed. So students, here we are going to write it as cages are needed. Now students, you are going to write the question mark instead of this statement, because this one is our question portion. Here I have written a question mark. Now come toward our solution. So students, look at this, here we are going to divide our dividend with our divisor. Firstly, you are going to separate the divisor and the dividend. So students, total number of birds are our dividend, and the birds in a cage, in one cage, is our divisor. Here I am writing my divisor and my dividend, that is 296. Now students, compare the first two digits, as my 2, that is my first digit, is being smaller from my divisor, so I will have to take the 9 with it. This will become the number 29. Now read the table of 8 to get the number 29, or the number that is lesser from the number 29. So students, as 8 threes are 24. So students, as I go to the table next to the 3, 8 4s are 32. I can't write the 32 here. I will have to write the number 24. Now in the next step, we are going to do the subtraction. 9 minus 4 is the number 5. Now students, this 5 is smaller from my divisor, so I have to take this 6 down here. And now this will become the number 56. Read the table of 8 to get the number 56. Yes, very good, 8 sevens are 56. Now students, look at this, we have divided our question completely with no remainder, or the zero remainder. Okay students, now students, can you tell me that how many cages are needed to accommodate 296 birds? Yes, we should have the 37 cages. So students, here I am writing as cages are needed, the question statement as it is, that is cages are needed, and next to it my answer, that is the quotient of my solved portion, and that is 37. So students, how many cages are needed? We have needed the 37 cages. Okay. Next is the question number 8. Now students, look at this. Half the number of children at a school picnic are girls. Half, which means that 1 by 2. Now students, half of the number of the children at a school picnic are the girls. Okay, you are going to tell that if there are 152 children at the picnic altogether. So students, if there are 152 children in total, then how many girls are there? So students, you are going to tell them that how many of them are girls out of 152 children. So students, the procedure is same. We are going to divide 152 by the number 2, because half is showing with the number 2. So students, we are going to divide the number 152 by the number 2, and there will be the number of girls. Okay, look at this students, total number of children are 152 and girls are half of it, and you are going to find out the total number of girls in the numbers. Here is our my question mark showing that you are going to find out the number of girls in the total number of children. So students, here the half that is being divided. So here is my solution. Here I am writing the solution. In the solution, my dividend is 152, while by my divisor is, look at this students, this half is divided earlier. I'm gonna write it as, when we do it inverted, this will become the number 2. Here I am dividing it with the number 2. This is showing the number half. While I'm going to do the division, I'm gonna divide it with the number 2, because half of which means it is divided into two parts. Okay students, this also means that 152 is being divided by the number 2. Okay students, now let's start division. Firstly, we will compare the two digits, 2 with the 1. 1 is being smaller, so here I will have to take the pair of this, will become 15. Now read the table of 2 to get the number 15, or the number that is smaller from the 15. So students, read the table of 2. 2 sevens are 14. So in the next step, that is subtraction, here I'm gonna subtract the number 5 from the 4, and that is the number 1. Now students, 1 is being smaller from the 2, so I have to take this 2 down here, and now this will become the number 12. Read the table of 2 to get the number 12. 2 6 are 12. Okay students, now in this step, next is subtraction. You are going to subtract it again. 12 minus 12, that is the 0. Okay students, 0, or the no remainder, which means that we have divided our question completely. So students, can you tell them the number of girls? Yes, the total number of girls are the quotient of this question, that is 76. It means that we are having 76 girls in 152 children. Okay students, now students, come to the next part, 9, question number 9. How many packs of 4 biscuits can be made with 735 biscuits to be distributed among some children? So students, here in the first line, there is a question that how many packs of biscuits will be formed. Here is our first question, and each pack is having the 4 biscuits. Okay students, how many packs will be made of the 4 biscuits, while in the total we are having 735 biscuits. Okay students, here in the first line, we are having the 2 statements of our answer and 1 question, while in the next statement, how many biscuits will be left over. You are going to find out the leftover biscuits. So students, here we are going to find out first that how many packs will be formed and how many biscuits will be left over. While each packet is having the 4 biscuits, and in the total we are having 735 biscuits. You are going to write it in this way. First of all, biscuits in each pack. So students, in each pack, how many biscuits we are having? We are having the 4 biscuits. While in the total biscuits are 735. So come to our next question portion, that is pack of biscuits. You are going to find out it and the biscuits that will left over after the packing. So students, here we are going to divide it, and our dividend is 735. Here I am writing my dividend 735, and above this my divisor, that is the number 4. Now students, compare the numbers. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Can't write the 8, I will have to write the number 4 here. 4 ones are 4. In the next step, that is subtraction, 7 minus 4 is 3. 3 is being smaller from my divisor, so bringing this 3 down here and making my number 33. Now read the table of 4 to get the number 33 or small from the 33. Now students, read the table of 4. Yes, 4 8s are 32. I can write the number 32 beneath this. In the next step, that is subtraction again, let's do the subtraction. 3 minus 2 is 1. Now this one is again smaller from my divisor, so I am bringing this 5 down here, that is left over in the dividend portion. Now this number will become the number 15. Now read the table of 4 to get the number 15. Yes, 4 twos are 8, 4 threes are 12, and 4 fours are 16. Can't write the 16 here, so I have to write 4 threes are 12 here. Okay, because 16 is bigger from my number, but 12 is smaller and closer to the number 15. Next step is subtraction. 5 minus 2 is the number 3. Now this 3 is my remainder. Now students, look at this. Come toward our question portion. In this we have asked the pack of biscuits. How many pack of biscuits? So students, there will be 183 packs of biscuits. Next question was, how many biscuits will left over? So students, after packing, there will be 3 number of biscuits that will left over. Now let's write these statements again and the answer in front of these statements here. Look at this students, pack of biscuits is 183 and the leftover biscuits are 3. Okay. Come towards our next question number 10. In this, 910 soldiers marched in the parade ground in 7 rows. So students, how many total soldiers we are having? We are having 910 soldiers. Okay. That have marched in the parade ground in the 7 rows. How many rows? 7 rows. Now you are going to tell them how many soldiers were there in each row. Okay students, here we got now about the number of soldiers, that are 910, and the total number of rows, that are the 7 rows, and we are going to tell them that how many soldiers are there in each row. Okay, let's write the statement first and then solving this question. Here is the question number 10, and the total number of soldiers are 910, while the total number of rows are the 7, and you are going to find out the soldiers in each row. Okay students, so the procedure is same and very easy. Here I am writing my division sign, that is dividend is 910, while my divisor is 7. Now students, compare the first digits. 7 ones are 7 because 7 twos are 14 and can't write it here. In the next step, that is subtraction, 9 minus 7 is 2. Here I have written the 2. The 2 is being smaller from my divisor. Can't divide it further without bringing this one down here. And now this will become the number 21. Read the table of 7 to get the number 21. 7 threes are 21. Now students, 21 minus 21 is 0. I will not write the 0 here, but this part of my dividend, that is 0, is unattended. So I have to write it here. So students, this 0, now look at this, 7 ones are 7, can't write the 7 beneath this 0. I have to write 7 zeros are 0 beneath this. Now in the next step, 0 minus 0 is 0. Now students, here we have completely solved our question and we have found out that in each row we are having 130 soldiers. Students, look at this. This 0 is my remainder, which means that we are having no remainder. Look at this, students, how many soldiers we are having in each row. In each row we are having 130 soldiers. Okay students, now you are going to write this statement as it is beneath this and you are going to write the answer in this row. So students, we have completed our question number 10, world problem, still the question number 10. So students, you are going to write and you are going to practice these questions on your notebooks. Okay students, take care. Allah Hafiz.